Even if he doesn't come out on top, I don't see how he can. But even if he doesn't, it's another part of Trump, what he did for us. Exposing it. They're gonna have to fix this shit. I'm telling you, you gotta show up on voting day in person. This should be a cardboard cutout of Trump or whoever you're voting for. You know, like at the fucking mall. Something like that. And then they put a thing on your forehead. You dip your head of your dick in purple ink. Whatever they do in Tehran seems to work. Sun Tzu. He's pulling a little Sun Tzu on. I wonder if he went to Wharton Business School. They give you that book. Sun Tzu is required reading. Because it's a war when you're in business, you know? But not everybody. Everybody that's seeing how much corruption's going on during this election, they're not all partisan people. They're not all fucking Republicans. What do you mean, Nick? Well, there's a human rights attorney. What's her name, Jace? I know you got it there.
Lee Dundas.
What is it?
Lee Dundas.
Lee Dundas. She might even be gay. I don't know. I'm just going by the haircut and the glasses. But she's a human rights attorney. They're usually a little left of center. She's upset about what went on during this election. And let's take a look at Lee Dundas.
They have late ballots that are still dropping. They are uniformly breaking in favor of Trump, such that Biden's lead is down to about 20,000 when a few days ago it was five times that. They are going to continue to break in that direction, and if so, we should be good to go. If not, when it's within 1%, there's an automatic recount, as I understand
it. Is that Georgia? I know what you're talking about.
A party can request a recount. Georgia is already going to a recount. The Secretary of State there, Brian Kemp, is a Republican. He's the same guy. They have lots and lots of overseas
same
military
guy.
Ballots that are still
Pause.
Outstanding.
She just says he's the same guy. That's where we are. That's where we are, folks. Well, he's the same guy. Yeah, he is. She doesn't look like a Trump voter, I gotta be honest with you. She looks like the bastard daughter of John Elway and Kitty Carlisle. I don't know. Whatever.
And it is likely going to be weeks, I repeat, weeks before Georgia can be properly tallied.
My state!
Which means nobody at this point should be calling the race. Also, they have evidence of illegal ballot harvesting in multiple counties in Georgia, and they believe the recount, they know the recount, is going to shine a light on this, bring all of the fraud to the surface, excuse me, to the surface, where the ballots that were not properly tallied, and again, once we know how it's going to shake out, and it's going to shake out in Trump's favor. In Nevada, they have 15,000, if I did not...
Not even mentioning the military ballots. The 8,000 or whatever. I think we can assume those are going to be for Trump. It is a mess out there.
What the hell's going on out here?
I don't know, Vince. I'll tell you what's going on, Vince. Donald Trump, maybe one of the most popular presidents of all time and unpopular, but blinded the left with their hatred so much. They're so crazy. They want him out so bad. They don't even know how to cheat. They've lost their goddamn minds. And they've tried to do anything to get them out. I'm loving it. Go ahead.
Misunderstand them, mail-in ballots that still haven't been counted, and 68,000 provisional ballots. There are literally thousands and thousands.
Provisional ballot is a ballot that's under question. They set it aside for whatever reason. And then they try to figure it out after whether it's good or not. That's all that means good.
Thousands of voters who never should have voted in Nevada.
In Nevada.
Lawsuits have been filed. Clark County DA's office has been notified, as has William Barr in the Department of Justice. All of those investigations are being commenced. And again,
these
inconsistencies, anomalies, and straight up election issues that never should have occurred have been handled. We have a close race there, but it's a doable thing. The other thing to know about Nevada is 90 days out, guys. Apparently, their legislature or governor, I'm not sure which, rammed through changes that allowed for massive mail-in voter, and their voting lists weren't up to speed. They weren't properly pruned out and weeded through. It resulted in hundreds and hundreds and thousands of ballots going out multiple times, two, three, four times over to people at different addresses, and we all know where that ends up. Again, these are things that need to be cleaned up in future years. Pennsylvania, they have 80,000 mail-in votes and 105,000 provisional ballots still outstanding.
105,000 provisional, what I just told you, that are under question. unfriggin', and that's in Pennsylvania. Trump was up by 700,000 votes in Pennsylvania on election night, and he's losing by thousands. Lick a bag of shit. Are you kidding me? That looks so suspect on its face. Fucking Biden, what does he do? He sits there going, I hope he doesn't. I remember my dad near the end. Like, I'll look at a TV, he'd just go, what the Christ? It's probably Biden, they're trying to explain it to him. Fucking, you're up 700,000, almost a million. And you're gonna tell me those rallies with 30,000 people as opposed to Joe Biden in front of 20 cars. That means nothing to you. This isn't even about Trump and Biden. This is bigger than that now. Let her roll, Sonny.
Biden thinks these are going to break in his favor. The Trump campaign has reason to believe otherwise, particularly with the provisional ballots. As we all know, the Trump campaign was barred. They were actually prevented from having observers in the process, even after the courts ordered Pennsylvania to stand the hell down and let us observe. If you don't have transparency in the voting process, you don't have democracy in function, or in fact, you don't have a constitutional republic. All of this stuff is now coming to light. They also, like Georgia, have thousands of overseas and military ballots, if I didn't already mention it. And as we are learning, and the Trump campaign is well ahead of us on this, they had statistically impossible voter turnout, which has already been referred for investigation. And they have multiple cases of counties curing deficiencies in ballots. And we all know what that means. Putting addresses on them and signatures on them when they didn't arrive with them, and doing things that should never be allowed in any sort of honest election. Again, these are the types of things that are coming to light and are being handled by the Trump campaign. Wisconsin. There were tons of irregularities on election day. The recount is starting next week. I just want to conclude with this, guys. There's a recent study that came out, literally I saw it this morning. Mathematicians, statisticians, and economists are concluding, not entirely. These are subject matter experts who have conclusively now weighed in and said that the Biden math is not just statistically improbable, it is statistically impossible. And I'm going to give you a couple of key quotes from this.
Hurry up,
the voter turnout in Wisconsin apparently annihilated the historical record of 66% by almost 30 percentage points.
Pause. What they're saying is usually about, in the counties or whatever, about 50 to 60%. 66% was the record for turnout. There was like, I don't know how many counties in the Milwaukee area in Wisconsin where it was 95 and above the turnout. Just this year, they must have felt strong about that, huh?
No.
Oh, yeah. Go ahead.
The odds of this occurring are 0.00000. That's 50.
Just say zero.
You guys, 0.00000189%.
Oh, no!
Or 1 in 52 million. Statistical analysts have noted that this 5-point deviation was not only a statistical improbability, but a virtual statistical impossibility. I am reading direct quotes from this article, which will be in the...
0.000189. I didn't realize that mattered. I watch a lot of investigative TV. That's like when a guy rapes and murders a woman, and 20 years later they put his shit in a DNA bank, and is, you know, a 1 in 52 million chance that it's not him. I mean, are we supposed to ignore this? You know? Even Fox now. I don't know about... Got to say goodbye to them. You know, they're calling it for Joe Biden. Ooh. And then I read today, well, even Jared Kushner is telling Mr. Trump that he may have... Really? Who gives a fuck what Jared Kushner has to say? You can see Trump, yeah.
You dumb Jew bastard. I'll let you marry me. We know you're half a fag.
Don't fucking listen to him. He was part of the cancer act. This is stunning, is it not, though? And then in Nevada, former AG of Nevada, Adam Laxalt said, talking about a lot of there were signatures. It was tallied by a machine. Is this the clip? And not by human beings. They used this program that apparently doesn't have a good reputation.
And in particular, the Clark County Register went with a machine called the Agilis machine.
Oh, pause! Not the Agilis machine! I use that at the gym. Fuck my back up on the Agilis machine. The Agilis machine. Go ahead, he'll explain what it is.
And at least 200,000 votes were counted through the signature verification process of this machine only. I repeat for the media, no human beings looked at those signature matches to confirm they were in fact matches. Now we have...
Oh, fail the energy.
No.
Okay, machines. All these machines have a lot to do with tallying all this shit up. The Agilis machine. That's the other thing about the high-tech world. You know, I told you guys about the, what was it called, scorecard app that they use, and the hammer. The hammer, we're going to talk about that in a second. That's the program that our country uses on other countries. When we stick our beak into some country's election, they turned it around and used it on us, the American people. That's our agencies and our government. If you got, that's why I'm saying it's not about Trump and Biden. You guys should be shitting your pants. That goes on in third world shithole. You know, people climbing over the fence with their fucking 2-year-old kids? They're fleeing from that shit. Coming here. They can be victims of it now. You lefties. You fucking people. You have no idea how to defend a nation. You have to ask me nicely, Danny. Does it not go against everything that... You put on NBC, CBS, ABC. They have no proof. What are you talking about? How can it be a Democrat Party after this? Where do they go from here? Which is the way that's clear? Still looking for that blue jean baby queen. Prettiest thing I ever seen. See her shake on the movie screen. Jimmy D. Hey everybody, this episode of my show brought to you by Sheath Underwear. I love Sheath Underwear, you know I do. I'm wearing them right now. I don't have the green. I like the camouflage ones because it hides whatever I do in my pants. They're great. I'm telling you. Soft as a girl's underwear. Now, don't take the wrong idea, but honest to God, I was always a tidy whitey guy, you know? And like I said, then I saw my picture over the Hitler mustache, so I was looking for something else. Lo and behold, it's got a two-pouch compartment. Keep your balls off your legs. I have an extra nut, so I'm sewing a turban in. Supportive soft material, nice looking. I just told you why I like them. The idea for Sheath came from U.S. Army soldier Robert Patton. The idea during his second tour in Iraq. Guys, if this worked for Robert and the sun blasted of Iraq, you know it'll work wherever you live. Support this awesome veteran-owned company. He deserves it. It's actually a great product. Go to sheathunderwear.com and use promo code NICKDIP to get 20% off your first order. Every order comes with Sheath's underwear, 100% money back guarantee. That's sheathunderwear.com, promo code NICKDIP. Get Sheath underwear and let them support your big balls. Even you transgender folks. Maybe you gotta change your different underwear now. You got a different equipment down there.
That's just the way.
I like my tidy whities. They get stretched out and you like your left nut tangles. At least at my age. Really cool. Much longer than my penis. This is it. More cheating going on. Which one's this, Jace? I let the thing roll.
This is Detroit.
This is Detroit. Tony Burton, listen up. Anybody else that hates Trump, listen up. Of course, you're not watching this show because you might be enlightened. You fucking baby. Anyways, this is in Detroit. They're actually state employees training vote counters how to cheat. Listen, it's like a military class. They have to yell back answers and shit. Of course, there's an ignorant minority woman who's been doing this for years. Nick, what's that got to do with everything? They call useful idiots. And you're not going to believe this shit. It's just, even Jason was like, what? And I said, come on, man. You lived in the hood. You know what's going on. Oh, boy. I got sick on this. I gotta be careful. I didn't play this during the last story.
Danger, Will Robinson. Danger. No, Will Robinson. Danger.
Go ahead. Check this out. Again, real quick. This is in Michigan, Detroit area, I believe. And it's a woman teaching the young people who count the votes how to cheat. Let her roll. The vote fraud scheme.
The chairperson can issue him what type of ballot?
A provisional
envelope. Why? Where's it going? Not in the tabulator. It's going in that envelope.
Pause.
Right?
They have a separate envelope for the provisional one. You know, the sketchy ones? And not in the tabulator, which would straighten it out. Not in a tabulator. I can't hear you, shitbird. Not in a tabulator. Where you from? Detroit. Only two things come from Detroit, steers and queers. I don't see no horns on you, private. Go ahead.
We have how many days?
I don't know. I don't count that high.
So what is the Department of Elections going to do with it?
Multiple Detroit poll worker trainings were audio recorded, which revealed the mechanics of the planned steps of the election. They demonstrate exactly how things will and will not happen on election day. I'm reading the question. Step one, kick out the poll challengers.
Challengers and poll watchers. They have to wear a mask and they have to stay 6 feet.
Pause. What does that tell you? What was I saying about COVID being a whole part of this? You don't think they were thinking of this? Going, they have to stay 6 feet away now. That's what they're gonna use, COVID excuses. You dirty bitch.
It's important because they can come behind your table. But if you don't have 6 feet, they can't come back to you.
Pause. I'll read the question from the trainee. So they're 6 feet back. Unless they have really good vision, they can't actually see. And the trainer says, exactly. Go ahead.
Unless they got really good vision, or they bought their binoculars.
Unless they bought their binoculars.
6 feet. That's the rule, right? And you are entitled to your 6 feet.
I'll give you 2 inches.
Is that common? I mean, can we expect that? Yep.
Pause. Trainee, is that common? I mean, can we expect that? In other words, the pulse watches to show up. And Flip Wilson says this.
Coming.
Yep, there's a coming.
They're coming. I don't know if they're coming to every precinct, but they're coming to many of them in the city. Yes. We have already got them out. The state has already seen it. They're coming. And the basic thing they're going to challenge is what? They have to be bad. That is true.
Yeah, what evidence? Hey, NBC, Lester Holt, CNN, any token Asian woman they put on the left. Hey, Maddow, with your giant Adam's apple. Fucking Hitler's wonder. Well, what fraud? What evidence? These are baseless claims. Really? Not watching what I watch. And that's the, well, you're gonna have a fan base like mine that's saying good shit. Any more of that? Pause. Teenage trainee. They're using teenagers, by the way. What if they're challenging and they started yelling and making a scene?
911.
Call 911.
They got standards. They got conduct standards. Okay. They make a scene, give them a buddy.
Call the police on him like you did my cousin Ray Ray. As regular ballot, instead of separating them. This is a ballot tabulator. It looks like a Xerox machine. Before 2020, no challenged ballot would go into the tabulator. This is because every ballot inside the tabulator is anonymous. That's not true. A tabulated ballot could not be identified or challenged in the future. So before 2020, all challenge ballots were separated. They went into a challenge ballots envelope for future processing by the whatever. Now, as of 2020, however.
How do you challenge a ballot? You take the ballot, you write in the, under the barcode 2003.
I did this for a few years.
The post-it tape.
Post-it tape, bitch.
But this time, we're going to put it in a secrecy sleeve, and Mr. Starks is going to go vote as normal.
Pause. John Starks? Who they talking about? That's an... I think they're using a guy's fake name as an example. And Mr. Stark is going to be to vote as normal, even though his ballot should be questioned.
So his ballot is going through what?
The tabulator, motherfucker. Yeah, bitch. Translation. All challenge ballots will be counted immediately on election night, and only if after the fact a challenge ballot is rejected will an election official locate the ballot box, break the seal, and fish out the challenge ballot from the pile of thousands to find the one with a post-it tape covering up the challenge ballot. This will never happen unless maybe in a recount. Oh, my God. Step three, allow anyone with an easy voice to use some paper. Oh.
All right. Page 15 is an example of a new voter registration receipt. What can we do now as we vote? We can register to vote up and through election day. The computer system, the electronic poll book program is downloaded on Saturday before election day. It is not a live feed. So if someone registers on Sunday or Monday, they're not going to be in your computer. But they should have a receipt
when they register.